Hey guys, today I have the weirdest camera setup to record for you because I think I lost my selfie stick when I was in Madeira. Since I came back, I couldn't find it. That's why I haven't been recording videos for like almost a month now. So I have lots of books and then I have my protein shakes, and that's how like I made the setup. And I have my flowers for my mom, because in Poland we have a Mother's Day today, so it smells incredible. So what I wanted to talk today is like the most interesting topic for everyone. If you are thinking about Pinterest, like the first thought is like, okay, what am I gonna get from it, right? Like, I don't want to invest my time not knowing whether I'm gonna get a return on investment or not. So there obviously are several factors that are going to determine whether you're gonna get a return on investment or not. And that's what I want to talk to you about. If you don't know me, my name is Joanna Szewczyk and I am Pinterest expert. I help people get traffic from Pinterest, help them set up their Pinterest accounts so they can attract their target audience, they can attract people to their websites and sell their whatever product services they are selling. So conversions. So in any place where you have your content, whether it's Facebook, whether it's your website, whether you're using organic marketing, whether you're using ads, right? The first most important thing is what kind of content you have, right? Is this the kind of content people are searching for? Is it the kind of content that is like valuable information that gives them tips, that gives them advice, that gives them solution to the problem that they are having? Or maybe it's just like, you know, like a news, like Kim Kardashian is getting a divorce. Like, there are people who give a shit, right? There are people who are gonna be interested in it. But having this kind of content and expecting that I'm gonna sell my course or my product because I have like a news kind of article, it's just not gonna be there, right? You can get the click through rate because people may be interested in something, but the need for the product is not there, right? So the two things that you have to focus on is like, one that I can help you with is like all the technical setup, how you can make sure that Pinterest is showing your content to the audience, so it's showing up on top of search results, it's showing up in people's feed. And then the second thing, when I don't have so much control over, is the actual content that you have, right? So the first thing, do people even see it in Pinterest, right? That's the part I'm helping you with. Once people see it, is it what headline is it and what graphic is it? Like, is it grabbing their attention? Like, is it in their feed but it's like so ugly or like so blunt, like that everything else is like just grabbing their attention but your content isn't grabbing their attention? They're not even gonna read the title. Then when they read the title, what is it gonna be? Like, imagine you have a beauty brand, you're selling like conditioners for hair, right? There's a lot of people who have hair and they want to use conditioners. And they want to use conditioners for various reasons. How to fix damaged hair, how to get my hair more moisturized, how to grow my hair faster, what kind of conditioner, what kind of mask can I use for this and that, right? These are the kind of things people would come to Pinterest, they would come for Google, because they go to search what is necessary, like what kind of products, what kind of, you know, substances have to be in the conditioner for it to work. So they look for information. So when you have an article saying five tips that will help you get your hair soft and shiny, right, people are gonna click on that and they're gonna say, okay, I need keratin, I need biotin, I need this and that. And then you have the perfect solution for them. You can offer them the product that's showing that you have all those things, that it's natural, that it's organic, that doesn't have chemicals, etc., etc., etc. So those are the three things. First, the people have to find it in their feed. And that's what I'm helping you with, the technical setup. Second, having the image, right? Having the headline set up in that way that people really want to click on it, right? And then on your website, you can have terrible website or you can have amazing website, right? You can have amazing article that helps them solve their problem and provides them with solution that your product is. It doesn't have to be a product. I just gave you an example. It can be course, it can be coaching, it can be legal services, it can be augmentations, like surgeon services, right? It can be anything. So whether you are a professional coach or e-commerce business owner, Pinterest can work for you, of course. So yeah, those are the most important things. If you have questions, if you feel like your brand could benefit from getting the exposure, having the content properly presented on Pinterest, and you want to have this setup properly done, right? Because on the other hand, you can have the best content that you know performs well, and maybe you're running ads to it, maybe you have influencers that run a traffic to your website and it's selling really, really well. And you're like, okay, my site converts already, right? I already have conversions, so I just need more people on my website. So you're just looking for, you know, more more traffic sources. Then Pinterest is a great idea for you, because with sites that are already converting, having the proper content strategy and having the proper setup, you can get more traffic. But if you are trying to figure it out and like, I think that, okay, it's gonna be the same like Instagram, and you're gonna post in the same way that you're posting on Instagram, your results are gonna be so minimal that you're gonna come to conclusion that Pinterest doesn't work. And it just doesn't work like Instagram. It works completely different, so you need a different setup. So that's the important thing. So if you have questions, if you feel like Pinterest could be something that could benefit your business, reach out. And I'll try to help you out with the course or maybe done for you. Bye.